cars and trucks snowed in and stuck on the highway now have a deadline to move or else. We'll show you the best view of how Kentuckiana is dealing with all the snow and now a record deep freeze, and how people working outside are doing what they can to beat the bitter cold.
The 5 o'clock news is up in just 1 minute.
This is Kentuckiana's 24-hour news channel, WHAS 11. Live at 5 from the leader in television news, Gene West, Julie Koenig with the job file, and Chuck Taylor. This is Kentuckiana's news channel, WHAS 11.
Snowbound and stuck on the interstate, cars and trucks are finally moving, but not on their own. They're being forced out.
Good evening once again, everyone. Here at 5 o'clock, I'm Gary Rodemeyer.
And I'm Alyssa Swan. All cars and trucks blocking the highway now have a deadline to get out of the way. The state is demanding all vehicles in the way must be moved by 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Now, the big towing operation was supposed to start earlier today around 1 o'clock, but was anything moving on the interstate highways at that hour? Let's check in tonight with our Bill Menish, who joins us live from Spaghetti Junction. And Bill, the question is this towing operation going on out there?
You know, we have been on the road the entire day. We heard roughly mid-afternoon about this plan from the governor about moving the cars, and I got to tell you, we've seen a handful of tow trucks. Not one of them has been doing it for this state. So the word is that's what they're doing, but you aren't seeing it. Now, right here, if any cars are in the way, these three definitely are. We are right as you get on 71 coming into the city where you merge into 65. And obviously, these folks were trying to make it into work, couldn't make it, and abandoned their car right here in the middle of the road. Definitely in everyone's way. Now, we talked to people today when we heard the word about the mandatory move-out. Truckers are the ones who have definitely had to pull off either to the side of the road or wherever they could, and they're the ones that seem to be most affected. When we asked them about moving out, they said they don't mind moving. They want to get on with their business. They just don't like being pushed.
Because yesterday was the snow day, today is the tow day. Everybody's willing to lend a hand. They even have the formula for the three-piece tow.
Took two Chevys to pull a Peterbilt.
Well, that's about equal averages, yeah. Right?
Pretty much.
Finally, man. I'm tired of being here.
It's great to be free again, but those still stuck are up against the clock. Move it or lose it. Your cash, that is. If the state moves your car, you pay. And that's not a popular idea with the truckers.
I don't like it because right across the road here is a National Guard with a big old record with chains on it. They didn't even offer to help pull us out or nothing. I know there's a lot of people stuck, but we're just trying to get out.
Just trying to get out. They want to get back on the road. They want to get that load delivered to where it was heading more than 24 hours ago. Now, I've made a couple calls today to try to figure out exactly what was going on here. I called three tow companies. On all three of them, no one could help the truckers we were trying to lend a helping hand to. In fact, I made the first call at 9 o'clock this morning, and they told me that if you weren't already on the waiting list, it was a 24-hour wait. That puts you at 9 o'clock tomorrow, 1 hour past the deadline that the governor set for 8 a.m. in the mandatory move. Gary?
Bill, I know people wonder how we get to the interstates. My understanding is the side roads, the streets downtown that give access to the interstates are much better than the interstate highways, which are still clogged.
Well, it's a mixture. It depends on where you are, and it's a mixture no matter where. You see cars just like these that are abandoned in the middle of the highway. You see cars abandoned on the off-ramps, on-ramps. Again, the conditions are terrible, let alone the littering of the cars. They want to get them out here. These cars are in perfect shape. It's almost amazing. We pulled up and said to ourselves, why are they still here? They look like they're fine. Well, it's a matter of them getting out here to get to the car to move it, and who knows what's blocking them. It depends on which exit ramp or on-ramp they take.
And, of course, people are being told to stay off the interstates, so they don't want to violate the governor's order to stay off the interstates.
Vicious cycle, isn't it?
Yes, it certainly is.
Thanks, Bill.
Thank you, Bill. And Governor Jones's order that closed all Kentucky interstates remains in effect.
The highways will remain closed except for people transporting food, medicine, clothing, or other emergency items. To the south, Kentucky interstates have been closed at the Tennessee border to non-essential traffic. In an address to the state today, the governor asked for patience while the snow changes all of our lives.
Once again, I ask for the understanding and the patience of the people of Kentucky. We are licking this problem, and if we continue to be patient, we continue to work together, we will be able to make certain that everything is not only under control, but is well taken care of.
Now, it means that cars abandoned on major highways can be towed, and you would have to pay the tow operator to retrieve your vehicle. But there has been little evidence, as Bill indicated, of towing so far. The fee would include towing and storage. How much you pay is up to the individual tow operator, and you will have to contact the police to find out where your car has been stored once it has been towed.
Now, the best way to look at the highways, interstates, and the streets is from Sky 11. You get a broader view at this hour.
The News Channel's Julie Koenig has the view from above with our continuing coverage from the helicopter. Julie, how does it look tonight?
Well, Gary, as you're right, this is the best way to get the entire big picture and more exclusive live pictures from Sky 11. We are above Spaghetti Junction right now. You just heard Bill's account from street level. As you can see, the roads and the ramps leading back into that tangled mess of concrete still littered with some trucks and a lot of cars that are stuck, especially as it's coming in on a 64 westbound approaching Spaghetti Junction. In fact, there's one ramp coming off the Kennedy where not two trucks are stuck, but actually three now. So we aren't seeing any evidence of towing whatsoever. One traffic note to pass on to anyone who might be coming into town from the south part of the county. We heard that there is a semi jackknifed in the northbound lane of I-65 right at Fern Valley Road. Again, a semi jackknifed at I-65 northbound at Fern Valley Road. We are headed there next. We've only been up for a few minutes. And we're also going to check on our stranded truckers that are down on I-65 south near Brooks Hill Road. We'll have those pictures for you a little later in the show. So far, so good. Rush hour, for what we can see, is moving as smoothly as it possibly can. Gary and Melissa.
All right. Thanks, Julie.
Best we've seen in a long time. Well, if you weren't stuck or snowed in, you might have been freezing on this day after the big snowfall.
It might have caused you pain to go outside today with temperatures in the single digits and wind chill far below zero. But the biggest pain may be what is happening to our water here in Kentuckiana. The Ohio River is in danger of freezing for the first time in more than a decade. That means even more problems for Louisville's water company, already fixing a high number of water main breaks.
The cold water coming out of the river is one of our concerns. That cold water going into our distribution system is what causes us problems with breaking water mains.
The suggestion from the water company is that if your heat is off or you've had problems in the past with pipes freezing in your home, run a very thin stream of cold water from your faucet.
So when can we expect any kind of warm-up at all?
Meteorologist Chuck Taylor has more information about that right now. Chuck?
Well, it looks like we are going to come out of this deep freeze, but it will be late in the week or into the weekend. In the meantime, we're dealing with records. This morning, we set a record. It got down to 10 below zero, and that was after the sun came up. We're looking for another record tonight, and record tying, 14 below zero right now. It's 6 below. We do have a wind chill advisory in effect. Really, don't go out unless you have to, but if it's an emergency and you have to go outside, remember these cold weather tips. Wear loose and layered clothing. Wear a hat and mittens. Don't overexert and stay out for very short periods of time and check on children and the elderly. I'll be back with a forecast that calls for a little bit of snow in just a few minutes.
That's all we need. Now let's update the city's efforts at responding to the snow emergency.
The News Channel's Lisa Chiava is at the City County Command Center with the latest information.
It is day two of the big storm. Lisa, how are they holding up down there?
Tired, but they feel like they're making some progress. We would like to correct some misinformation about towing. We have new towing information, and I think a lot of people are going to be relieved. Joining us now is Mayor Abramson with that information. What do you think is going to happen with these cars that are on the side of the road, Mayor?
Well, what we're doing at this point, no car is being impounded. The people keep using that term. That is not the correct term. For the state to be able to plow the expressways, they've got to clear the right-of-way. They've got to clear the way to be able to get the plows through. So the cars are either going to be moved to the side, or if they're close to an off-ramp, they're going to be towed off and onto the street. Now, there'll be a towing charge, just like there would for anybody having a private tower come and move them. But no daily impoundment or anything of that nature. So where people are getting that idea, it is not true.
So in some cases, if you get pushed off to the side, you're not going to pay anything at all.
The odds are you're not going to get a call from anybody on that one. If, in fact, you're near a ramp so they can get you down the ramp and get you completely off before the plows go through, then there'll be a charge for the wrecker crew that tows you, which would be the normal charge for anybody that unfortunately has their car in a ditch or needs a tow. But no impoundment, no day-in and day-out charge, whereas like the state government is going to take over your car or something. That's not going to happen.
The deadline for 8 o'clock that the governor has mentioned. Do you see that happening?
Well, we're certainly working toward that goal. I know the Kentucky Highway Department is the one that's implementing this, and they've got contractors they've got to find, and call a wrecker right now and see if you can find one to help you out.
Right.
So it's going to take some time, but no car is going to be impounded. I talked to the governor this afternoon. That term impoundment is incorrect.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. So that's good news for motorists worried about their cars stranded on the side of the roads. You're not going to be calling local police departments wondering where your car is in the vast majority of cases. Gary, Melissa?
All right, good news. Thanks, Lisa.
Thank you, Lisa. And area shelters will keep their doors open tonight for anyone looking for a warm place to stay.
While many are filling up, they are taking anyone who comes in. Let's take a look at the Bullitt Central High School, now a temporary home to about 500 people. Many of them are travelers from all across the United States who got stuck in the snow yesterday out on the highways. Many of them say they are now concerned that they will be stuck where they are through the end of the week, but at least they have a place to stay. Well, if you need a warm place to stay, here are the area shelters where you can go.
There is the First Church of the Nazarene, 3503 Blanton Lane.
News on Kentuckiana's news channel, WHAS 11, is sponsored by Suburban Medical Center, a special kind of care.
Temperatures have shut down just about everything the past 2 days.
But in today's job file, the news channel's Stephanie Collins shows you some businesses that are up and operating despite the treacherous ride to work.
Can I have some wine, please?
And you can count on McDonald's shut down yesterday. Long lines of hungry folks today.
There is no place open. Now you either eat at McDonald's or you don't eat.
Over at Walgreens, other necessities.
Soft drinks, liquor, bread. I got a little bit of milk left. And some orange juice.
For 25 years, Don Stewart has reported to work here through sleet and hail and snow. Did I say snow?
We got 500 snow shovels.
Okay.
And we got rock salt.
Ace was the place today, and today was its day to make money.
This is calcium chloride. It runs $3.99 for 10 pounds.
Shovels, salt, heaters. Business is good here.
Thanks for calling AutoZone. It's Jim.
And business is good in Shively.
It's been fairly steady. A lot of phone calls.
And while a few stores are open like this AutoZone, they're oftentimes out of the one thing that customers want to buy. For instance, ice scrapers, a real popular item right now. 97 cents, not a single one left in the store. The other item, cable chains, ranging from $35 up to almost $49. A real popular item right now if you want to put some chains on your car. As you can see, not a single one left.
Three cheeseburgers and a large fry.
Now back at McDonald's, no shortage on food, just employees. So there was a limited menu. Hamburgers, McNuggets, no problem making a sale.
70 fries, 70 cheeseburgers, 70 hamburgers. So it's pretty wild.
We're one of the only stores open today, I believe.
No, sir, we're totally sold out of chains.
Plenty of business and plenty of money to be made today. And if customers couldn't come to you, you came to them.
Oh, you can't beat it. Shoot. No kind of way. Oh, it's cold out there.
Yeah, it's cold outside, but for some business, that was their hot ticket. Stephanie Collins, Kentuckiana's News Channel, WHAS 11.
It has been tough going for the people who depend on TARC, but the bus company is giving it a try today.
Try as they might, many buses didn't get very far. Fighting both the cold and frustration, drivers are moving slowly in Louisville. We found this stuck TARC bus getting a tow out of the snow not far from the News Channel here on 5th Street. TARC buses stopped running routes at 5 o'clock today. Tomorrow they'll start in at 5:30 a.m., running only on the major roads.
And so four-wheel drive vehicles have been the transportation of choice for the past 48 hours. In many cases, the four-wheel drive volunteers have been the heroes of this snow emergency.
And if you own a four-wheel drive vehicle or have an emergency and need a ride, here's the telephone number you can call. That number, very familiar to most of us by now, 574-3900. Again, that is 574-3900.
And the storm team continues to track the winter storm of 94.
Meteorologist Chuck Taylor has all the latest details on the cold when we come back.
Smile every time you turn the key.
But we're still the great
Fast 11 storm team. Meteorologist Chuck Taylor, Ken Schultz, and Ashley Chisholm. The WHAS 11 storm team.
There are no major storm systems affecting the country tonight. Eventually, though, a weak disturbance developing in the Rockies will push eastward and affect us here by tomorrow afternoon. But as you can see, there is no moisture associated with this system. Now, the system that gave us all the heavy snow and sleet and ice was pulling up a lot of moisture from the Gulf of Mexico, but this system has very little moisture to work with, and as it pushes eastward tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow night, we're going to see a little bit of light snow. Some areas we'll see a dusting to maybe a half inch of snow, but that will be just about it. There are showers down in southern Florida and patches of light snow along the east coast, but the main thing everybody is talking about today is the temperature. A tremendous Arctic high-pressure system is centered over in Missouri, and that certainly is controlling our weather here and brought the record lows this morning and will bring more record cold tonight. Now, these are current temperatures up at Indianapolis. Currently, it is 11 below zero. It is 12 below up around Chicago. You can see the cold weather extends well to our south. It's only 19 at Memphis, 9 degrees at Nashville. And here in Louisville, it is 6 below zero. Our humidity is 58%. We have those west winds at 16, giving us a wind chill of 41 below. The barometer, very high at 30.56 and going up. Our high occurred at midnight. That was 3. Our low this morning, 10 below, a record. We've had a trace of snowfall in the past 24 hours. Tomorrow, as the high moves out, very weak disturbance moves in from the west, bringing us a little bit of light snow. After that, we definitely will see a thaw. For tonight, a record tying 14 below zero. Then tomorrow, look for a little bit of light snow in the afternoon, a high of 8 above. Tomorrow night, light snow will continue off and on with a low of 2 above. On Thursday, the snow flurries will end, a high of 18, up to 30 on Friday, 38 on Saturday, and we'll keep going into the 40s and probably 50s next week. So big thaw is on the way.
All right. Thank you, Chuck. And in case you were wondering, still trying to find out about this, school closings in our area. All schools are closed in our area for tomorrow, with the exception of the University of Kentucky in Lexington. They are going to try to open their doors tomorrow. But as far as Jefferson County Public Schools, private schools, parochial schools in this area, they are closed tomorrow. And we will be updating that again later on during our hour and a half.
Now, more about the cold. As Chuck indicated, most of us can stay inside and stay warm. Emergency crews, though, are working outside doing what they can to beat the cold.
News Channel's Chuck Olmstead shows us how workers are snatching up boots, hats, and whatever they can to stay warm.
100 degrees, you put them on top of your boot,
Jim Gilroy was stocking up those cold hours tonight working at UPS.
Well, we're getting some mittens and some face masks and some hats.
Diesel mechanic Larry Crossan was here at the Sports Unlimited store off Preston 2 before he hits the highway to try to get some of those stranded 18-wheelers going. And what should you have on? Start, say the folks here, with thermal underwear, then some insulated pants that can be had for less than $20. Now on to the gloves.
What you want to do there is you want to have a good pair of Gore-Tex gloves, Gore-Tex and Thinsulate insulated gloves. What the Thinsulate does is the insulator, and then what the Gore-Tex does is it is totally waterproof.
And perhaps the cheapest insurance of all in cold weather like this, you may want to try some of these pocket hand warmers. They can be had for just a couple of bucks. Chuck Olmstead for Kentuckiana's News Channel, WHAS 11.
Our storm team coverage continues, but first, a look at what's happening across the country.
Including how California residents are picking up pieces after yesterday's killer earthquake. We're back after a quick look from Sky 11 and a short break. Of course, here at the News Channel and in our immediate area, we've been concentrating on the emergencies right here in our backyard, digging out from this major snowstorm and dealing with the bitter, bitter cold.
But nature has also dealt a devastating blow to the folks in California, now digging out from yesterday's earthquake. Already, the death toll has risen to 34 with the discovery of another body in a crushed apartment building. Many people struggle to get by with no power and no water. Thousands of others are left homeless. The California governor, Pete Wilson, says it could take as long as a year before life gets back to normal in the Los Angeles area.
And Tanya Harding is hoping her life will soon get back to normal. She also told reporters her husband will not be arrested in connection with the attack on skating star Nancy Kerrigan. Harding took to the ice this morning, but later faced questions from a district attorney. Authorities are trying to find out if any of Harding's money or funds from Olympic sources were used to pay for the attack. Several reports say financial records connect Harding's husband, Jeff Galluli, to the three men already arrested in that case. Our complete coverage of Winter Storm 94 continues.
Doug Proffitt joins us right now for what's coming up in the next hour of news. Doug?
Good evening, Gary and Melissa. Hello, everybody. Coming up tonight at 5:30, we're going to focus our snow coverage on how people are handling day two, from the hospitals to the shelters.
They have come together from across the country, an unexpected tourist stop in snow-covered Bullitt County. Tonight, the hundreds of folks stranded by the winter storm. Plus, how are hospitals coping with this emergency? Tonight, find out what's keeping them up and running. And from your power to your phones, we'll look at progress on one front and pure frustration on the other.
More local coverage coming up on WHAS in just a few minutes. I'll see you then.
Thanks, Doug. The snowbird of this storm has been the News Channel Sky 11.
And we'll be back live with Julie Koenig and The View from Above as our coverage continues.
Profile free.
Back in now with the News Channel's Julie Koenig, who has the best view from the situation from Sky 11. Hello, Julie.
Hello again, Melissa and Gary. The best view, probably the coldest view as well, high above the city. Once again, we want to show you some of our exclusive live pictures. This should be a familiar sight to our viewers in Kentuckiana by now. Yes, we're back here, I-65. We're actually heading now north, but you're looking at the southbound lane. No, it's not gridlock. It is a parking lot. The same semis, probably in excess of 70 of them, that were stranded starting yesterday. 24 hours later, they are still here. We have seen a little activity. There's a truck stop there over to the left, and there have been some truck drivers walking around, kind of checking out the rigs that are stranded there on that exit ramp. You know, the unfortunate thing is that up here, while it's been a very chilly ride, it's also been a very beautiful ride. Lots of pretty pictures to show you. So why don't we take a chance and look at some of the prettier sights the winter blast of 1994 left behind.
Sunrise on the Ohio, a sight that warms the soul. Unfortunately, the sun isn't warming Kentuckiana. Steam rises off the mighty river as this lonely towboat pushes its load west. And here's a sight we haven't seen in a while, patches of ice near the shoreline. From the frozen waterway to frozen roadways, I-65 at Spaghetti Junction looks more like a toboggan run than an interstate. And here's the scene further south on 65, high above one of the worst weather-related traffic jams. Dozens of trucks stranded along the highway near Brooks Hill Road, like so many toys left out by a child. From Sky 11, Kentuckiana looks like a scene from Courier and Ives. A belated Christmas card, compliments of Old Man Winter. If only it was a Christmas card. If only the pretty picture above came without the harsh reality below.
Back here in Sky 11, showing you live pictures of I-65, the southbound lane, as you can see, jammed with trucks. We'll be keeping a watchful eye on our friends down there at 6 o'clock. We'll bring you more live pictures. And a reminder for those of you who are going to try and get into work tomorrow, we'll be up tomorrow morning giving you the bird's eye view of rush hour traffic. Gary and Melissa.
I wish it had improved, but it hasn't. Thanks, Julie.
Thank you very much, Julie.
And our coverage of the winter storm and the killer cold continues in a moment.
Doug Proffitt joins me next for the latest on how Kentuckiana is coping. Stay with us.